Part 2, Gal Score, Evelyn's Creation, and the Stalking of the Dreary Ones. Mini Chapter 15, Amber Incarnate in the House on Electra Drive. This corporeal Amber, standing in a human frame here in Jaymi's house, is brutal in a literal sense. Although he's clothed and ready to function in society as a somewhat dangerous-looking person, Jaymi knows very well that this is an animal of a kind, a human animal in meat space, not artwork in a game. Those muscular bare arms on him are made of flesh. His wide-set eyes are staring straight into his maker's with what looks like shrewd intelligence and a flicker of humour beneath the surface. And now his face is tilting down from within, while his eyes continue to look at Jaymi's eyes, like the downward tilt of a cheetah's gaze just before it springs. Jaymi flicks his attention away from Amber's face, then masters himself, masking his alarm to the extent of slipping his hands into his pockets. He affects leisure in his movements as he wanders to the window and peers out, registering absolutely nothing beyond the glass, while his mind is busy wrestling his terror to the ground and pressing it into submission. It occurs to him that things have just changed in a fundamental way. However he may choose to conduct himself with Amber in a moment or two, as he'll have to, nothing will be the same from here on, because a beast from one of his own games is standing right behind him, so dangerous and beautiful here in his own house. A weapon. It's clear, too, that Amber is much the physically stronger of them both. From where that beast is standing, there comes a quiet scratching, thrice, which Jaymi guesses is the sound of Amber's fingernails running over the flesh of his opposite forearm, and Jamie's own flesh runs hot and cold at once. Okay, the only thing to do is to brazen this out. Act with decisiveness, then let it flow. So he turns with a movement of easy confidence to face Amber, and the very next sound is his own voice addressing his beast. He listens to himself with amazement to hear the words of one who sounds so authoritative, so sure of what he's doing. Amber, welcome. Here is your mission. It is vengeance, in the face of dreariness, laziness, and smallness. In the wake of your vengeance will come transcendence and fierce beauty. You will see that there are lies which I'll send you in pursuit of like a wolf. You will clean those lies away, so my truth can take their place. You'll be lighting up and lifting up the world by an inch or two at least. Do you understand? Amber's nod is sharp-eyed, simple and serious. Do you accept this mission? Yes, I do, states the beast. Thus does Jaymi Peak find himself giving instructions to a personification of his own darkest, righteous violence, the first time he's met it in the flesh. How natural it felt to issue the instruction. No, it felt more than natural. It felt irresistible. He has an uncomfortable feeling he has just committed himself to a grand elemental conflict of some kind.